I see something down there.
Where were we then? Oh yes, my first job. I couldn't have been much older than you when I started. A fairy king's errand boy and unofficial jester. By night, my mates and I had the run of the forest. Good fellows they called us. Knavish spikes to the last. We'd get up to all manner of mischief, making fools of the local mortals. But as long as our lord was kept amused, we were spared the consequences. Oh. Then one day he was not amused. And I saw fit to move on. Thankfully, the ages and roads travelled since then have turned me from that merry wanderer into the paragon of virtue you see before you today.
We could beach the boat here.
Well, looky who decided to show. Talk to this here ring.
What? I can't hear thoughts from rings, Brock. It's talking to me! It's Unvari!
Ha! Knew it.
He says he went to the Velander mines to observe his mistake, but then the Soul Eater attacked, so as he was being ripped apart, he cast a spell that removed his soul and put in this ring. And then he...
What about all his stuff?
Unvari
had a workshop here with all sorts of posh doodads and ornatory tools, and one beaut of a hammer. You make mention of it still in there?
You're upsetting him.
Your point? You fellas take Unvari with you and go have a look-see. If you find his hammer, I'll whip up something real nice for you. Hey now, don't go forgetting your entry stone.
Unvari isn't happy about us taking his stuff.
I do not care.
I'm not gonna tell him that.
Sorry, not that.
says this dwarf was part of his crew. That he died because of his mistakes. He sounds sad.
The ring's grief is of little importance, boy.
He did not like that. He's warning us not to go down there.
Stop listening to the ring, boy. It cannot be trusted. Silence that ring, boy.
I don't know how.
And a traveler. Guard up.
Oh, boy.
A dead soul eater. What's a soul eater even doing here? What do you mean it's your fault?
Boy, ignore him.
It's sort of tough for me to ignore. He says this chest was under a bunch of traps.
I see no traps.
Sounded so sure about it.
Says his workshop is up there. But I know. Don't trust the talking ring.
Focus up, boy!
Oh, no!
That's showing him.
Boy.
Father, please, just listen. Invari's crew did something bad here. He's glad you destroyed his lab, and he's sorry he kept trying to trick us. His hammer is just through this gate.
Boy, over here.
Sir. Wonder who wrote this.
This is a fine hammer.
Invari says thank you.
We will talk to the blue one. Here. Boy.
Yes, sir. Hey, it's another treasure map.
Find that hammer, or you too busy looting every keyhole and cranny?
Here, the alchemist's hammer. His spirit is a nuisance.
Yeah, Anvari always was an asshole. Hell of an alchemist, though. Hand him over here and I'll melt him down.
What? You're going to melt down your friend?
A trapped soul's what I need to give your reward some extra oomph. You don't want it?
Father, we can't do that. Here, you hold on to him. He's really useful, I promise.
Fine. So long as he proves his worth.
Kid's a bit of a softy, huh? Well, he'll grow out of it.
Thank you.
Come here. How'd you come to be in these lands?
Lad, there comes a time in every man's life when he changes his name and heads north to make a new start. If you live long enough to do this many times over, you might end up as far north as this place. By the time I arrived, I already knew Odin by his reputation, and so I set to demonstrate my worth by coming to him with something I knew he'd value. A mystic well of knowledge. Or rather, I should say, a well of water laced with enough mystic mushrooms to make a god see visions. Oh, he was rightly impressed. Can't say for sure what he saw that led him to try gouging out his own eyes, but I managed to restrain him before he finished the job. Then I persuaded him it has been his sacrifice made for an even higher form of sight to be bestowed. Blah, 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 blah. I used to think he never caught on, but the day he took my eye, I realized he had never been fooled. He knew I'd outwitted him, called the lesson wisdom, and hired me to make sure from then on I was on his side. And for a long, long time, I truly was. Doesn't mean he didn't hold a grudge.
We can beach over here. Different realms. Do you think that Fafnir went to Alfheim too?
I do not know.
Aren't you curious? He sounds interesting.
We go to the storeroom to collect anything useful for our journey, not to learn more about the dwarf.
Fafnir was a rather interesting fellow, little brother. Perhaps I'll tell you a story one day.
Have you made it out of Fafnir's storeroom yet?
Reavers.
Uh-oh. They must have gotten here first.
Oh! Atreus, to me.
Locked. Find another entrance. Boy.
Another map. Great.
Looks like the Reavers made it inside. I hope they didn't take all the treasure. Some stupid pots. Draw them. No magical treasure, and no whetstone.
Keep your expectations low, boy, and you will never be disappointed. You off guard.
I wasn't expecting them.
Exactly. And useful resources. The main reason we are here, boy. However, many of these chests have been emptied.
Probably by the Reavers. I hope they didn't take Sindri's whetstone.
Find the whetstone.
Remember what I told you about expectations, boy.
Keep them low. I remember. Still, good feeling.
Behind you, Mother!
Prepare yourself!
I was ready for them this time.
I saw.
So I should keep my expectations low, but always expect an attack?
It is a delicate balance. Expect the worst. Assume nothing. And always anticipate an attack.
Sure is a lot to remember. Whetstone. And only one room left. I know I shouldn't hope, but do you think we'll find it there?
No.
Huh.